there's a problem in the world that there's not an equal representation of women and men in STEM, science, technology, engineering, and math fields. And we need to empower more young women because that is one of the fastest areas in which they can gain economic independence. I believe this is a solvable problem. My name is Deborah Berebichez. I am the chief data scientist at Metis. Only 24% of STEM jobs are occupied by women. And more dramatically, if we look at the top tech firms in the world, only 11% of top executive positions are occupied by women. We encounter a tremendous amount of bias and ethical concerns when the people developing the technological solutions to our world are only men. When the airbag was created to prevent injury during a car accident, it was designed by a team of men. Most women, the size of their bodies was smaller, and so they kept getting hurt. It wasn't until women were included in an engineering team that the problem was solved. So we need to add more diversity to create products and solutions and software that actually is as little biased as possible. I believe the solution to the gender equality problem in the sciences is threefold. First, we need to empower young women to take risks and fail and learn from that experience because that is what science is all about. The second solution comes at the college level. The majority of women in science have expressed that they have experienced some form of gender discrimination. We need to enact better policies to have safe environments for women to pursue their careers. And finally, we need to empower women in leadership to rise to top levels of technology firms to encourage other young women who, like myself, feel attracted to the STEM fields. Growing up in Mexico City, I was discouraged from pursuing a career in science because I was a girl, and that was not very feminine. And so I learned to hide my love for physics and math. Fast forward, I applied to the US and I won a scholarship. I met a mentor who changed my life, and I became the first Mexican woman to get a PhD in physics at Stanford. Now I devote a lot of my time to develop workshops and to encourage other women to join STEM careers and to succeed in them. This is the moment where we need to solve the problem. We are living a technological revolution where economic independence can be very quickly gained through having access to STEM jobs. Imagine a world where there's an equal amount of women physicists, mathematicians, and data scientists as men. I'm absolutely optimistic that we can solve this problem.